So, with people getting mad views with this whole anime review thing, I figured that I would totes be original-like and try my hand at it as well. And what better way to start than with some old-ass Letterboxd show that no one gives a fuck about anymore. I am, of course, talking about Gunsmith Cat. Now, just like every other anime ever, Gunsmith Cats has its origins as a manga. A manga written and illustrated by Kenichi Sonoda. The man responsible for... well, not much really. Apart from various Gunsmith Cats mangas, he also did some character art for Bubblegum Crisis, which is sort of highly regarded, I guess. And the only interesting little tidbits I could find about him after doing some research is that he's a self-confessed gun fanatic and that he owns several replica guns.
Better strap this motherfucker down, cause he's about to bust a cap in your ass.
Either way, the Gunsmith Cats manga was relatively popular back in the 90s, so it warranted its own OVA. A whopping 3 episodes, I might add. So, yeah, let's get down to business and review this motherfucker already. The story of Gunsmith Cats follows the tale of two bounty hunters and arms dealers called Rally and Minnie. Both of them get blackmailed into taking down some criminal scum. But of course, plot twists and stuff happen and things pan out differently. Now, with that being the main premise and Minnie actually being an ex-prostitute, you'd think that this show would be pretty fucking dark. But it really isn't. It's a fun swashbuckling adventure, but then without any actual swashbuckling and also not a whole lot of adventure. It's basically just Lethal Weapon, but then it stars two anime chicks. The soundtrack is just as sax heavy, there's plenty of quote-unquote comedy, and half of the show consists out of the shooting of the guns, all of which it does relatively well. One could pretty much sum it up as
birds what like shooting blokes,
which is exactly what I'm summing it up as. Really, the bloodlust is strong in this one, as both Rally and Minnie are exceptionally excited about the idea of shooting dudes in the face. And that makes the show a lot of fun in a popcorn-y kind of way. It is, for all intents and purposes, a mid-90s action movie. So don't expect any emotions to occur while watching this. I mean, there really isn't a whole lot of character development, you know, with the runtime only being about an hour and a half in total. But I'm not really sure that a show like this really needs to be anything more than that. Also, it is based off of a fairly long-running manga, so I assume most character development takes place there. It is still perfectly watchable on its own though, as I didn't know a single thing about the manga and had no problems keeping up with it at all. Now, with this being an anime from the 90s, it's obviously going to look like an anime from the 90s. So, there will be plenty of deformations and other types of bodily dysfunction going on with the characters here. Though, I've definitely seen a lot worse as it doesn't stray into Sailor Moon territory. But if you expect all of your anime to be just as squeaky clean and perfect as the shit you're used to watching on Crunchyroll, then maybe this isn't for you. It's an acquired taste, sure, and for the longest time, I too considered myself far too snobbish to watch anything that dangerously close to my day of birthing, but I can't help but fall for the charm that 90s anime has sometimes. Things like shamelessly ripping off American movies and then reappropriating tropes and pop culture without fully understanding what exactly they were dealing with. And when mixed with Japanese tropes and pop culture, it makes for something quite unique despite its somewhat copycat-ish origins. Now, I've considered doing some kind of rating system for these, but as I don't do that for my game reviews either, I'd prefer to stick with the style I'm comfortable with. I'd much rather have people make up their own minds based on the info and opinions that I gave them instead of shitting on everything I just said with a score that may or may not summarize the tone of the review all that well. That's by no means a commentary on people giving review scores, mind you, but I just don't trust myself with the responsibility that comes with giving them, as it can drastically change how people interpret the review as a whole. Anyway, overall, the show is pretty alright. Nothing outstanding, and it's not gonna move you emotionally or evoke any kind of thoughts either. But it is a good show to watch, even if you're not really into that sort of thing, as it isn't one of those super weeby trope-heavy shows. It's pretty down-to-earth as far as anime goes, and it's very much inspired by American cop drama movies, so that's pretty much what it feels like. And if any of that sounds good to you, then I totally recommend giving it a watch. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some yaoi to get back to.